Today I'm starting a new project to include file-based green screen in a Unity virtual environment. Now, what is a file-based green screen? Well, it's where I've pre-recorded the green screen video beforehand. Now, that's different from real-time green screen where we are able to shoot the green screen and show the person inside the environment. Those tutorials are coming, but we need to get started with file-based so that you understand the basic principles before we move into mixed reality where we're doing live capture of green screen into the environment. So I'm going to start today by setting up the scene or the virtual environment. Virtual production is being used widely today for film, television, anytime where we've got to add special effects or place a person inside an environment that we just reasonably, fiscally, reality-wise cannot do so. So for this tutorial, we're going to be using Unity 2021.3. We're going to use some Ready Player Me avatars and pull those into the environment. And we're going to set up our environment using a Kitbash 3D project. But before we get started, make sure that you've paid the class fee. You need to click on the like or subscribe button down below. And if you haven't clicked the notification bell, I suggest you do that so that you know when the next video in this tutorial series is available and you can keep moving forward on making your virtual production. Okay, let's get started. First, let's open up Unity through the hub and create a new 3D project. Now, when I say 3D, I mean 3D. You need to do a 3D core. Do not use URP, do not use HDRP. For whatever reason, when I'm importing the assets in URP, it doesn't properly find all of the graphics, and I know that the green screen project works with 3D core. So we're going to use 3D core for this project. We're going to go to my project, and I'm going to call it green screen file, just to keep it clear. We'll go ahead and create the project, give Unity a few seconds to get the project open. Now, while that's opening the project and getting everything set up, with all the core assets, there's a couple of things that we can go ahead and download for your project to make life a little bit easier. First of all, and it's a fairly large download, let's take a look at Kitbash. Now, I've downloaded and purchased a couple of kits from the Kitbash. I'm going to be using Americana for this project, but the Mission to Minerva is a free project. Link to the Mission to Minerva is in the description below, but you can go to Mission to Minerva, select it, put in your email address, and then you can download it. When you're ready to download it, and here I've got it on my system, when you're ready to download it, just simply go to tell it that you're going to download it for Unity. You're going to use the built-in rendering engine. We're not using HDRP. HDRP process is different. I might do a tutorial later if there's enough requests in the comments down below. Then just simply hit the download. I've already downloaded this, especially the Americana. Once it downloads the system, once it downloads everything, go to your 2K that it's going to give you, and that's going to be all of your PNG files, the meta files, all of that. I want you to select all of those and copy them. Part of the Americana, when you download it, it's going to include basic materials, but it's also going to have all of your FBX files, and then it's going to have another folder called Common Textures. Now, I've just simply placed this on my desktop. Common Textures is actually an empty folder. I want you to copy from your 2K or your 4K if you went with that download, and we're just going to copy that into Common Textures because that's where Unity is going to look for these textures inside of the 3D project. So we're going to paste those into Common Textures. Once you have pasted those into Common Textures, just take your Common Textures and drag it onto Americana. That's going to give you the folder inside of everything else. So there's my Common Textures, there's all of my PNG files. It's all set to go. I just need the Americana file now, so I can get rid of these two files off my system, save a little space there. And once this Unity gets opened up, we'll be ready to drag our Americana into the project. That'll take several minutes. Last time I did this, it was about 5 minutes to do the entire process. Jump over to the Ready Player Me, and you're going to need to download the Ready Player Me tool or Unity package so that we can do the proper imports to it. Now, I've already done that. The link is down below in the description. Download the Ready Player Me Unity package. So once Americana or Mission to Minerva finally imports, I go into there. Now you can see it is properly processed. I have all of my assets there. I can quickly import these into the environment. There we go. There's the first one. And I'm just going to build a simple environment real quick into this. Action movie. Scoot that over. I'm just creating a Main Street type scene, so I want something that people could drive down or ride their bike down, which is what my green screen is going to be. We'll just add a few more things to this environment, and I'm just going to quickly build a basic environment. We could add streets. We can that was a grocery store. Okay. We could add a plane in there and resize that 50. There we go. That gives me a nice ground. And then I could go to my materials, find some asphalt. There we go. That's now inside the environment. Might need to lower the buildings a little bit so they're not floating above my plane. No floating of buildings allowed unless the aliens show up. Okay, we've got a couple of buildings. So now we've got a basic environment starting to pull together. Let's pull that up just a little bit. There we go. And we can add a few more buildings. I'm going to add a few more buildings as we go along, but you don't need to watch me do this. But basically, we're just going to build a nice little environment that my plan for my movie is I'm going to be riding my bike, waving at people that are inside the scene, and then a spaceship's going to come down and I ride my bike in terror. So just a short little clip for doing this, but obviously I need some people in my scene if I'm going to be doing this type of an environment. So let's add some people. To do that, I decided I was going to go with Ready Player Me. Ready Player Me has some great avatars. It's simple to pull in. We can add some animations to them, nice and easy. So let's go through that process of getting your system ready to do that. First thing we need to do, besides save your project, save, there we go. Always a good idea to save. So I'm going to go to Assets, Import Package, Custom Package, and then on my desktop, I've got the Ready Player Me Unity Pack. So we're going to open that, and it'll bring in the import. Now we're going to have one of two things happen with this project. Okay. If you are in not using URP or HDRP, like I said, you will not have a problem importing this. If you try to use one of these others, this Newtonsoft.json collection is going to throw an error. Since I'm using 3D Core, I can just simply do an import and I should not have a problem. Once it does the import, it'll need to compile all of the C# files in your scripts so that everything will work correctly. And I did have a problem. So in my assets, I'm getting an error down here on the pre-compiled Newtonsoft JSON is throwing an error. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to delete that entire plugin. Everything was stored inside of plugins. And I'm going to do a assets, import package, custom package again, just for simplicity. Click open. I could have just gone in and deleted the JSON part, but I want to show how to do this as well the other way. So since that's throwing an error, I'm going to turn off the Newtonsoft.json so that it doesn't import any of these Newtonsoft.dlls. And why there's multiple ones included in there, that's what's throwing the error. You've got multiple Newtonsoft.json.dlls, and Unity does not like it when there's multiple ones of those. But you only need to do this if you get that error. We get our Ready Player Me menu at the top. So once this is finished doing this import iteration again, we'll start importing some avatars into our scene. let's talk about avatars for just a second. We have a variety of different places we can get avatars from. Ready Player Me is a great, easy to use tool set that works really well with Unity. I've already created some basic avatars to use with my environment, so I'm going to go with that. I could have used Real Illusion's Character Creator, which creates probably a higher quality and gives me a lot of more creativity with it, but it also costs a little bit of money to do that. I have the license for it, but for speed and the use of everybody for doing this, I'm going to go with these Ready Player Me avatars. So I've got my avatars. You can go to the readyplayerme.me website and see your avatars. If you haven't created some, go ahead and go through the process. It's just a matter of create new avatar, select what you want them to look like, and here I've created a basic six characters that are going to be inside my scene. So that's easy to do. To use your Ready Player Me characters, go to the Ready Player Me menu in Unity, click on your avatar loader. And then, as you can see in your avatar loader, it's going to ask for the avatar URL. So hop back to your hub. I'm going to go here. I'm going to copy the GLB, which is the file type for this. Copy that. URL is successfully copied. Paste it in there. And load the avatar into the current scene. It'll download the GLB file. I'm going to go ahead and use eye animations for this. I'm not sure if I am or not, but I'm considering it. It'll do the work. There's the character. It says it's now available in the scene. Let's find it. There it is. Floating up there in space. So let's pull her down so she's not walking on air or sunshine or anything else like that. And as you can see, the characters, already scaled properly for my scene. So that's really a nice thing. And there I've got a character. Now I'm going to go through, repeat the same process for each of my characters. It's exactly the same thing. Copy GLB, go back, paste, load avatar. And now we've got a second avatar, probably floating up there in the same place. Yes, he is. Pull that down and set him over here to the side. Try and not have him sliding into the ground. Okay, so I'm just going to, repeat the process for each of my characters. Okay, I've got seven avatars in here. I can, of course, create duplicates of these avatars. It'd be real easy to add more clothing, do all of that kind of cool stuff. But for right now, for this quick and scene that we're trying to create, we've got a small crew that we can then rearrange and place around our scene so that we're ready to go. Again, I'm going to save my project. And the next thing that I want to do is add some animations, right? So let's add a few animations. I'm going to use Mixamo for my animation tools. We've got some great basic animations that can easily be imported into your projects. One of the scenes that I'm planning with my green screen is I'm riding along waving to people inside the scene. So I need them to be able to wave back. That would be really nice. So let's see what we've got here for waving. We don't need that, no. Beckoning, waving. This little work. That's a nice simple wave. I want to then download that. I'm going to download it for Unity with the skin, 30 frames per second. We don't need to worry about keyframe reduction. So I'm going to download that one. May get a couple of different types of waves. So wave two, Unity with skin again, download. We'll let it do its thing. You can do it. You can do it. Got two waves in there. And then when they see the spaceship coming down, maybe we'll have the people start running away. Don't need a sideways. Don't need backwards. Let's do a fast run. And there's others in there as well. But I've got four animations to work with. If you want to get more for your production, that, of course, it's your production. So you should do that. So I've got four different files downloaded. Let's drag them onto our desktop here. Okay, so I've got my four animations here. I need to go to my plugins Ready Player Me, Resources, nope, not Examples, Resources, and we need to go to Animations. So we've got a talking and a walking there. Let's select these four animations and drag them into the folder, and it'll pull them all in. Now, we need to go through and we need to extract the animation from the asset that we just got from Mixamo. So I'm going to right-click on it, and I'm going to select Extract Animation. And I'm going to do that for each of the four files. There we go. So now we have our walking, running, fast running, wave, and wave one. So we've got now all four animations into the system. We're ready to go then. We actually don't need these files anymore, but I'm not going to delete them just yet. So we've got our animations there. Actually, we've now got our scene set up. We're ready to start placing our characters in the environment where we're going to do it, add the animations to that, and get our green screen into that. That's what we're going to do in part two. So if you haven't done it yet, make sure you click on the video and learn how to pull the green screen in. Cool stuff. We're having fun. Make sure you like and subscribe. We'll see you next time.